Philippine government aims to vaccinate against COVID-19 some 15 million Filipino children aged 5 to 11. Dr. Ted Erbosa, advisor to the government's Pandemic Response Task Force, says children with comorbidities will be prioritized. He adds minor adverse reactions, such as fever and body malaise, are expected following inoculation.
Kaya kailangan kasama ang isang magulang, usually nanay o tatay na alam yung mga sakit ng anak.
Yes, oh.
Allergy ba tong batang ito? May nangyari ba siya nung binakunahan ng ibang bakuna? So ito yung mga hinahanap ng mga assessor, no, mga physicians na naka-duty doon, at titingnan nila kung i-defer ba o itutuloy yung pagbigay ng bakuna sa bata. Kung ikaw naman ay may sariling doktor dahil meron ka ng kapansanan, ang hinihingi lang ng vaccination site ay medical certificate na pumapayag din yung doktor. Na bigyan ng bakuna.
And close to 90% of the 85,000 teachers in Metro Manila has been vaccinated against COVID-19. That's according to the Education Department amid talks of resuming limited face-to-face classes in the capital region now that it's under alert level 2. The program was suspended early January due to a spike in the number of coronavirus cases.
Ang tanong, paano kung hindi pa bakunado? Okay. Yan po yung aming ginagawa ng panibagong polisiya under the alternative work arrangement. Although hinihikayat po natin na lahat sila ay magpabakuna, pero kailangan po nating pairalin kung ano yung isinasaad at sinasabi ng mga kautusan, particular po yung mga resolution ng IATF na ipinatutupad.
The Philippines logged 9,493 new COVID cases Tuesday, the first time the daily tally fell below 10,000 since nearly a month ago. This brings the total to 3,569,000, of which 176,000 are active. The health department also reported 51 more deaths and 24,000 more recoveries. The Okta Research Group believes fresh infections might drop to around 5,000 a day by late February.
Kukunti na lang mga regions na may acceleration pa ng cases, kasama dyan Negros Oriental sa Visayas, tsaka mostly nasa Mindanao, kasama dyan Bukidnon at may mga iba pang regions sa Cotabato. So dahil konti na lang pataas at kanto'y may naipababa na, ang nakikita natin, yung overall numbers natin na kahapon ay I think nasa around 15,000 ay pababa na rin talaga. Hopefully talagang less than, mga 4 digits na lang yung bilan ng kaso.
Residents living near the Quezon Medical Center in Lucena City are complaining of foul smell amid the uncollected hospital waste from the facility. Many have expressed concern over the safety and health of nearby residents and workers due to the mounting trash, which include hazardous wastes from COVID-positive patients. The Quezon Environmental Management Bureau says it is investigating the matter, adding it has issued a notice of violation due to the improper handling of infectious waste. Hospital officials say they are now seeing double the volume of waste and their existing equipment can't handle the load. The contractor tasked to remove the trash has also ceased operations following budgetary problems from the provincial government.
At the start of this year, maghahanap na kami ng mga ng solutions yan, kahit man lang just to lessen yung kalat na yan. Katulad nung sabi ko, ilalagay na namin sa drums. Tapos yung payments naman, according to sa Kapitolyo, ay in process yung waiting na lang si pipick upin ng contractor.
The World Health Organization warns many countries have yet to see the peak of the Omicron wave. That's why it says governments should chart their own paths out of the pandemic and not blindly follow others in relaxing measures. WHO Director General Tedros Ghebreyesus also expressing concern about the false narrative surrounding Omicron. Because of vaccine,
we're concerned that a narrative has taken hold in some countries that because of vaccines and because of Omicron's high transmissibility and lower severity, preventing transmission is no longer possible and no longer necessary. Nothing could be further from the truth. More transmission means more deaths. We're not calling for any country to return to so-called lockdown. But we're calling on all countries to protect their people using every tool in the toolkit, not vaccines alone. It's premature for any country either to surrender or to declare victory.